Hello. Yeah, it's been a little while since I've done any sort of recording or anything for stuff. I know, it's been like 2 weeks. I'm so sorry. I'm just now, just recently, and I'm still tired as hell. I'm just recently getting over like a big major cold and flu that just wiped me out. And I was just in no shape to be streaming. I'm still kind of sniffly in coffee, so you'll probably still hear me sniffle or cough or something like that. I know that's unprofessional, but I don't care. This isn't a professional channel. I mean, yeah. I'm going to do my damnedest. And I'm really sorry. I've been sick as hell, and there was no way I was going to... there was no way in hell I was going to try to, do any of the, stuff that I would normally record, just because my throat was just, I sounded like, I can't even think about, like, who I would sound like, but it was just, like, really dark, it was just really low and raspy and, woof. Yeah. Use some sick days at work, too. I'm real glad I'm not a temp worker anymore. I'm real glad... Jesus, what was it, 2 years ago? Yeah, 2 years... was it 2 years or was it 1 year? Yeah, I can't remember. I can't even remember when I started. But yeah, I mean, at least now I'm not a temp worker, so I don't have to worry about that nonsense. But yeah. I was able to use sick days, and it didn't deeply affect me. So yeah, I might as well just get kind of started in on this. So yeah, apologies for not doing anything forever. There was nothing. I haven't done any of my games that I normally do. I didn't. Oh man, I was just. I was just wiped. So yeah. I'm glad to be feeling a hell of a lot better, and just in time for the weekend, too, because I got a fun weekend prepared, and I would have loved to do more recording, but I got a big Saturday as far as Thanksgiving / Christmas stuff with friends and other people. I mean, I did all the family nonsense already, now it's time to have fun. so, yeah, other than that, not a whole lot else really happened other than the fact that I've been super-de-duper sick, and I've been waiting on, trying to find a, because I think I've said it before, that I was planning on, like, my ability to stream again being probably, like, end of January, beginning of February. Which, might still happen, but I'm really, really, really trying to find something by the end of this month so that I can move in. And I found a great place. It's like 10 minutes away from work. It's like 5 minutes away from some of my friends. Oh, it's perfect. So I really hope I get it. I ended up calling them today. I can move through some of this while I'm doing this. Okay, my HDMI thing's going wonky on me. Nothing I can really do about it right now. It ends up going away on its own after a little bit, so I'm not too worried about it. So, let's see, 11 days, so let's go about 5. We'll go to that Saturday. So I can actually talk about stuff that's happened to me. Not much, other than being sick, kind of working, and then hunting for apartments, and I had put in for an apartment, today, or at least talk to a person. Hopefully I could put in an application on Monday, and yeah, it seems like a really good place for me to be, because it doesn't look like it's all that bad. I haven't really seen too much of the interior. I've only seen a couple pictures, but you know, I'm not too picky on my stuff, so we'll see. Amasis is unhappy. All right, well, let's see what we got here as far as Amazis is concerned. He is a mid-carder, so what? He should be an upper mid-card guy? Main event guy? You know, I know that's going to change. I just know it. I don't know why I'm doing it like... I don't really know why I have to do it like this, but whatever. I just know that it's going to change. Like, it's gonna. There's going to be somebody who's like, oh, man. You know, there's probably somebody who's a main event guy, like fucking Alpha Jr. or somebody who's like, ah, you know, you should be putting him as mid-carder, and he's a main event guy. TNA made a contract extension to him. PCW, okay, that's not really a big deal there. Ownership of Stardom is up for grabs. Huh, I wonder who's going to own Stardom now. That'll be interesting. I should really try to maybe get in touch with one of those people. So I'm going to get... I probably could have just checked right then and there, but I'm going to wait until Monday, because usually they process stuff for the end of the week. I'm assuming I'm going to be able to have a show when I normally do. But, of course, we'll see. Anything can happen. Let's see. So, yeah, I'm hoping to be streaming again very soon. As you can tell... Well, I mean, you can't see my cursor off the side, but usually right off to the side here is where you'd see a chat. And, obviously, because I'm not streaming, due to just... Oh, I knew it! Fucking Joel Redman and Marty Skrull. Well, I gotta have both of them, so... We'll just do something... We'll just move it to Sunday. Fuck it. Yeah, I gotta have them, so... I gotta have, at the very least, Marty Skrull. I booked him in the main event, for God's sake, so, yeah. Knew that shit was gonna happen. Damn. Alright. Other than that, not much. I just bought a new keyboard and mouse today. Oh, I bought a new laptop so I can work on some stuff. I wanted to do some writing. I wanted to start doing writing for NaNoWriMo at the beginning of November. Well, that didn't happen. But, yeah. I do still want to write some stuff. So, that'll be kind of cool. Hopefully that works out. Oh yeah, I put in a strap match. I wonder why. Alright, so no one's got anything for Sunday? Cool. I would just rebook it for Friday. I got a very good feeling that that Friday is going to end up getting taken. So I'm just going to do Sunday, because no one ever does Sunday. So I got a really nice keyboard and a really nice mouse. I mean, my keyboard and mouse still kind of worked okay. I had broken a couple keys on my keyboard, though. The mouse still pretty much worked, but... You know, it's good enough to just get the keyboard mouse combo. It's really nice. It's like a Logitech Wave K350. It's a big friggin' keyboard, and I kind of knew it was a big friggin' keyboard, but I didn't want to skimp out on my keyboard and such, considering I use it so religiously for gaming. And they don't skimp out on the mouse either. That's a very nice mouse. And that's the cool thing about Logitech. I didn't need to, like, get it, but I felt like I probably needed to replace it since it was getting a little worn. Head booking position, and he signs a non-exclusive contract with TNA. I wonder who's the head of Stardom now. Crap, where do I find Stardom? It's like... Pro Wrestling Stardom? No. I'll see where I can find it. It's not just called Stardom, no. It can't just be called Stardom. Oh yeah, they got Glow back. That's right. I'm looking for it. I'm looking for it. I know, I bet you I passed it once already. There we go. World Wonder Ring Stardom. Okay. Yoshiaki Yatsu. I don't really know much of anything about him. Let's see. He teamed with Riki Choshu. Okay. He left New Japan for All Japan. Oh, that was must have been great. His career started to decline in 92. Found out SPWOs, which had never encountered a great deal of success. So he's old school Japanese wrestler that got a little bit of fame, but not a whole lot. Yeah, well, good for him. Maybe he can do something to Stardom. I'm sure it was doing just fine on its own, but yeah. Okay. Let's see. Let me try to turn this thing down just a little bit here. So maybe my mic isn't picking it up as well. I'm sure my mic is picking up the fan that's on the other side of my room, too. That's all right. Okay. Sorry, I'm very tired. I've been tired all day. Finding apartments, hunting for them, and then calling people, and then dealing with apartment bullcrap is just so much fun. There was another place, too, that I'm planning on calling on Monday, because they didn't answer their phone. And I decided not to leave a message there, and I have a pretty bad feeling that what's it called? Oh, man, I can't remember. Oh, man, my brain is just shut down on me. God damn it. I probably make too much to live there. How about that? There you go. I probably make too much. It's rent control. There we go. So you have to have a certain under a certain income, and I almost certainly have too much. So I gotta have one of those regular apartments. What are those regular one-bedroom apartments that all have the same price attached to it? So I really just am picking the neighborhood in which I want to live, and all the good ones end up getting taken. So hopefully I can get something decent. Maybe the rent-controlled one isn't actually rent-controlled. Who knows? That would be nice too. But I bet you it is, because I had a friend who lived in another town, who lived in the same town I did. Same people own the apartment buildings that he used to live in, and they were rent controlled, so my assumption is that in this town it's also the same way. Either way, we're gonna be booking a show. It's been long freaking time. So I need to remember what the hell I was doing. All right, so let's see. Big O and Colby Carino were doing some stuff. Let's see here. Cody Hall wasn't around, I don't think. Oh, no, Cody Hall was around. Okay. Okay, so we're doing Shane Hollister and Cody Hall. That was a thing. Okay. So, perhaps Big O and Colby Carino now? I'm trying to think how well that would work. Alright. I think we'll start with a match. Oh man, who should we start off with? Let's start with Dalton Castle. We will open this up with just a short Dalton Castle. Actually, we'll just make it a straight match. We'll just open it right up with a match. And we will do Dalton Castle. Who should he take on? Ah, they're both heels. How about faces? Mark Sherman? Wouldn't be too bad. Actually, I got an idea. I'm gonna make it the Big O. We're going to put it about 10 minutes. We're going to do a Dalton Castle win, but we're going to keep the Big O strong. Open match. I say a flash pinfall finish. Interference ran by Colby Carino on the Big O. So that'll make that. I think that'll be a good thing there. All right, and then let's see, post match beatdown. It's got to be a 2v1, right? There's got to be a postman. Yeah, a postman. Post-match attack. Well, that's not quite what I want, but we might just do that. Let me see if there's anything else. There we go. We'll just do that. So Colby not Cody Hall, Colby Carino and Dalton Castle, the Big O. So that puts a little bit of heat back on Carino and Castle, because Carino's been getting bitched out constantly right now. So, and Big O's been he's been heating up a lot. If I remember right, Big O got the win there. Big O got Big O, yeah, okay, so yeah. Big O's been on fire the last few weeks, or the last few months that we've been around, so. Except for that. So the last two events, last month, he was on fire, so. And he bitched out Colby Carino, so Carino's got to get a little bit of something so that there's a feud here. Despite the fact that it wouldn't make too much sense to have tiny-ass Colby Carino getting the best of the Big O. So I think Big O is eventually going to get the better of Carino very quickly. But on this day, it's going to be Colby Carino and Dalton Castle. And Castle's not a big guy by any means either, so it's kind of... that's kind of why it's taken two of them. But Big O will probably eventually get them both. Because Cody Hall, they are not. Cody Hall could do it by himself, possibly, because he's big. But they just happened to get him this once. We'll add a quick angle. Let's see. Let's do two. Let's do two people. And let's do a self-promotion. It's going to be Marty Skrull and Scarlett Bordeaux. Take the scripts off both of them. Skrull will win tonight. Wow. My throat kind of made me go, Yeah, that was not... See, I'm still trying to get over this, but I do want to... I've been really wanting to play this, so... Let's do this, definitely. Okay, what else do we have here? Pete Dunne and Joel Redman have been doing their thing. Does Juice Robinson have anything to do right now? Doesn't seem like it. So Caleb Conley and Amasis, that should be a thing as well. Let's go up here real quick. Okay. So Caleb Conley and Amasis. That's a thing. So let's see. We didn't get Caleb Conley and Amasis this time. So what we're going to get is we're going to get Caleb Conley again doing this. Oops. Come on. Interview? No. Oh, there's no I. That's why. Because it's all... Okay. That's cool. Caleb Conley. Talks about... last month with Alpha Junior and vows to destroy Amasis tonight. 3 minutes, good enough. Let's not do that right away. Let's actually not do that right away. Let's do... Let me see something. I'm trying to remember the matches that I've booked with people so far. Okay. So... Joel Ridman. So Joel Ridman didn't actually compete last time. Or that's Infamous 7. He did compete at Infamous 8. But let's do that one again. And let's do Joel Ridman and... I'm thinking Yuma. Yuma's being very 50-50 booked, but we need to have Joel Ridman get some sort of heat together here. We already got Alpha booked. Amasis will be booked with Caleb Conley. We've done Ridman versus Robinson a bunch. Mark Sherman, maybe? I don't know what I've been doing with Mark Sherman. What have I been doing with Mark Sherman? What's his match history look like? Okay, he hasn't wrestled since Infamous 6, so he hasn't wrestled the last two times. I really don't want to... I may have to... I hate to do this to you, Mark, but... Mark Sherman may just get... He may just end up getting jobbed out here for a bunch. Which sucks, because what did I do? Okay, 1, he lost at 2, he won at 3, he lost at 4, he lost. So we've done Ridman versus Sherman. We did that 4 months ago. He beat Dalton Castle. So there's at least that. But then we haven't seen him for a while. But we're going to give them 15 minutes to do their thing. Redman's still going to win, though. And Sherman, open match. But it's still going to be a decisive win, nonetheless. I don't really think any shenanigans need to go on right now. Because I don't really have anything for Mark Sherman right now, so... Did I do anything with Mark Sherman last month? Maybe he was gone, and I just... It doesn't look like I've used him at all. I don't see him. I don't see him used at all. There. Did I use him at all? I didn't... Okay, this challenge is Dalton Castle. Alright, so he was doing his Dalton Castle thing. So now he's going to do his Joel Ridman thing. But then he's probably going to go back to Dalton Castle. Man, I should be coming up with good storylines, but realistically, I just got to remember that it's like 35 people that I'm going to be doing this for. So, but I still want to make it interesting, because, hell, I'm streaming this. So I'm doing this for more people in real life than I am in the game. So, okay. But this is going to be about Redmond. So, let's do self-promotion. Joel Redmond. And we'll keep him scripted unless he doesn't want to be. Promo about. He will come back and eventually become the Magnum Pro Champ. Because I don't think I have anything specific for him yet. No, I put Redmond in something. Pete Dunne, that's what it was. How about this? But he will use Pete Dunne as a stepping stone to the title. Here we go. 3 minutes. Keep it to 3. Alright, let's see here. Let's do... come on. One, ba-ba-ba-ba-bum. Da-da-da-da-da. Alright, we won't have him talk. Although we could probably, like, at least kinda talk. Probably at least, yeah, he can probably talk well enough to pull off a deal. In fact, we probably shouldn't use Overness for anything. Let's have him just, it's cool to have him be like, alright, I'm gonna, like, he's not talk, he's just the silent, you know, hyped up guy. He's just the silent badass. But, I don't want to use Overness for anything because it never works out well. So, yeah. Yeah, but we'll just do a backstage segment. Is ready for the strap match tonight. 2 minutes, short, sweet, to the point. Let's see, so we're 45 minutes in. We're good. So okay, let's see. Juice Robinson needs to maybe do something. Alright, we're gonna go to Alex Reynolds for this next bit. In fact, I think we could probably do some type of maybe skit or something with him. Come on. Let's see here. What can we do with one person rated on entertainment that isn't madness, because we don't need madness? Shit, we might as well just do a self-promotion here. Alex Reynolds is in the ring and runs down Zack Sabre Jr. verbally. He demands rematch at Infamous 10. There we go. So we will have 3 for this. Authority books 1v1. We really should have somebody else. Excalibur's good at doing that. I really wish I could use Brian Clark in this role. That'd be great. I should literally... Oh my god. Okay, so I have Brian Clark on as the road agent because I did a first run of this way before I even started this, and Vince Russo was it. Because then he could also be on screen, and that wasn't all that fantastic. So, maybe with Brian Clark... road agenting the matches, and then Vince Russo being the on-screen guy, that might work. I don't know. It just seems weird to have your head commentator also be the guy who's like, alright, I'm also making the matches. Something just doesn't seem right about that, but eh. So Excalibur, he makes... Oh my god. Okay, so we were going to have Zack Sabre Jr. and Alex Reynolds. I couldn't remember. I brain farted for a second. Trying to line it up. There we go. Alex Reynolds. Reynolds versus... Zack Sabre Jr. for Infamous 10 next month. Give that 3 minutes. How far into this CD am I? Okay, I'm close to the end. That's cool. And maybe I'll put on something else. We'll see. Okay. I'm just trying to see what I want to do. So we still got 50. We're less than an hour in. We've had two matches so far. God, we're turning into TNA right here. I mean, shit, we have pretty much half the time filled with matches, but still. It's a lot of angles. So let's do a match. Because we did promo, warm-up, Alex Reynolds, Excalibur. And we are going to do... Alright. We're going to do Alex Reynolds taking on... Who'd Pete Dunne beat? Pete Dunne beat Joel Redman. Shane Hollister. Should it be Yuma? We've done that match, haven't we? Alex Reynolds has poor chemistry with Shane Hollister. Mathis has awful chemistry with Pete. Pete Dunne has great chemistry when fighting Alex Reynolds. We've done this match, I'm sure, right? Right? We've done this match 3 different times. Well, okay, we haven't done this match in... What, 5 months? And with a 19-man roster, that ain't bad. And they were kind of, sort of, even. The rubber match was kind of a dual rubber match with Shane Hollister and Matt Cage's thing in there as well. So I think we'll do Alex Reynolds and Yuma again. We'll give them 16 minutes because I know they can handle it. I think. Okay, what? Oh, man. I wish I knew how long it was. I wish I knew that shit. I really should turn, like, the dirt sheet stuff on so I know when I'm booking something too long or too short or anything like that. Okay, so Alex Reynolds and Yuma. Alex Reynolds is gonna win. It's gonna be an open match. We're going to be doing... We're going to do outside interference finish. The distraction on Yuma is going to be from Matt Cage. So we got that. Because I believe that's what happened last month, as we had Yuma defeated Matt Cage. So Matt Cage gets a little bit of heat back in the realm of not winning. So Yuma's kind of the man, I gotta figure out this 50-50 booking thing. I don't want to turn in WWE where they're all just, nobody wins anything. Once again, it's not really a huge deal because I'm doing this in front of like 30 people, but still. Let's see. Alright, so we've got... Let's do Juice Robinson. I want to set something up because right now we don't really have anything for either one of them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do one. We're going to do self-promotion by Juice Robinson. Unscripted. I forget. He can do it, right? He's above average. If he doesn't want to be scripted, then fine. Talks in the ring about how he will once again challenge for the Magnum Pro title. Just something simple for him right now. Da, 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 da. Let's see. Let's do. Just a straight up attack, I guess. Cody Hall is going to attack Juice Robinson. And lays him lying after the outs. I forget if they call it the Outsider's Edge or Razor's Edge. Outsider's Edge. We'll just call it the Outsider's Edge. So now we got a little bit of something there. Perhaps for Magnum Pro 10. Match. Caleb Conley and Amasis need to happen. So let's get that in there. Let's see. Amasis. Caleb Conley. We'll give them 12 minutes. 10. Doesn't need to be huge. We'll let them go all out. Let's see how this looks for them. Amasis defeated Caleb Conley last time. Caleb Conley defeated Amasis. So we're kind of in the rubber match here. I say... How much time do we have? We are 75 minutes in. We have at least one more match. We're going to go to a draw for this, because we're going to make Infamous 10 kind of a big deal. Sort of. I mean, we have the big title match tonight, but, you know, we'll make it an open match. Go all out. And, we'll do double stoppage. I don't know. So we'll have, I don't know what else there should be. That should be about it. All right. So that ends in a draw. We'll figure that out later. Because I want to do the big match at the next one. With Infamous 10, that'll be the big... Because I don't want to do two big blow-off match. Because I feel like that could be the big... that could almost headline next month. Amasis is a main eventer. And Caleb Conley is upper mid-carder. So I bet you those two could probably headline next month. With Infamous 10, and then we can give them more than 10 minutes for their match. Because I feel like, since we are kind of at the rubber match, we can give them more than 10 minutes with a big blow-off for that. Alright. Let me see what other... Who haven't I used? Pete Dunne, Shane Hollister, Zach Sabre Jr., all faces. You know what I want to do? Let's do an angle. Let's do... Alright, so Pete Dunne is going to do a... backstage segment. Pete Dunne. Because I'm pretty sure he is really good. And cuts a promo about how he will not allow anyone to use as a stepping... Oh, crap. That's a promo about he will not allow anyone to use him as a stepping stone. Boom. With not a character to spare. We'll give him 4. Nah, I think he's 5 minutes. I think he could do 5 minutes, right? I remember his... Okay, I thought Pete Dunne's was really good. Maybe it was someone else's. We'll give him 3. So we're at 90 minutes. Alright, so... Oh, boy. So we still have Zack Sabre Jr. and Shane Hollister, who both are faces. I mean, they could do just like a friendly match, but I do want to see... what their match history looked like. I didn't use him at 8. Zack Sabre Jr. I know main evented the last match. Main evented the... Holy shit, does he have a lot of matches. He was used the last time with Alex Reynolds. So, alright. So we will have... Yeah, we will keep them from doing any sort of match right away. I bet his lowest rated match was one of my Magnum matches. I am almost guaranteeing you. Lowest rating a D. Check it out, ready? Boom, there it is. Zack Sabre Jr., Marty Scurll. Or it could be back here, too. Oh, we did like 4 different matches. I suck. Alright. So we'll just keep them from doing anything right now. I think. We're already 90 minutes in. We can go up to 150 minutes. So, let's book the main event real quick. And we'll get that figured out right now. So, we'll give them about 22 minutes. Afa and Noai to win. Marty Scurll to be kept strong. Open match, slow build, decisive win. Botched interference by Scarlett Bordeaux. Oh, no. Wrong way. There we go. Magnum Pro Heavyweight Championship. Alright. I think we're all good there. You know what? This would be a good time to bring in Hollister and Zack Sabre Jr. for that. We'll put them in a little thing beforehand, too. How about that? That sounds like that'd be awesome. So we'll do... Let's see. Post-match. Celebration. FNOI Jr. Yeah, it's going to be the end, and that's really not the best place to be doing a bunch of overness crap, and I've already talked about it, how that's not really necessary. But we're going to do a small celebration there. We're going to do... Here we go. Hollister, Zack Sabre Jr. Boy, I have Zack Sabre Jr. on the roster, and then I don't use him for more than freaking... You know, just the occasional match. One second here. Let's see. Psycho. Yeah. There's not going to be any issues with that. I just know it. There we go. Okay, so we got three. We got... Let's go back here. Let's do backstage segment. Backstage segment. Okay, cool. FNOI Jr., let's do Shane Hollister and Zack Sabre. Yeah, I have Zack Sabre Jr. on my roster, and I'm not using him to wrestle. No. He's gonna cut promos most of the time. I'm smart. To go out for his match. Hollister and ZSJ. Wish him the best of luck. Give it about three minutes. That'll be fine. Yeah, that's the smartest thing to do is... You have Zack Sabre Jr. on your roster? Why would you have him wrestle? Let's just put him in promos. I didn't use him. No, I used him last week. He headlined last week. He does a lot of matches. I can't remember if he's already healed up from his shit, but we'll... Physical. Okay, because he was at a point where he had a little fatigue, so it was like, okay, well, maybe not. Maybe not have to deal with that. Dalton Castle and Caleb Conley don't like each other. Okay. And I think that's how this show is going to end, right at 121 minutes. So we will, I think we run the show now. Everyone's been used in some way, shape, or form. So I feel good about that. Yeah, if I'm going to pay for them, I might as well use them in some way. Even if it's just a couple of segments I can get them in. There we go. All right. Dalton Castle and Big O, of course, didn't... Solid in-ring action. Okay, well... So yeah, Colby Carino came in and attacked Dalton Castle, rolled him up. Big O, of course, not happy about that, but Colby Carino and Dalton Castle beat him down. Of course it was going to be an F, because I believe that's an overness. Marty Scurll is very poor in trying to improvise dialogue. Scarlett Bordeaux worked the crowd well, using the freedom to improvise to her advantage. Maybe we should have Scarlett talking for him more. Caleb Conley struggled when going off script. I know he's good at it, goddammit. All right. Whatever. So yeah, Joel Redman and Mark Sherman. Sherman gets to be job boy for the last few months. Sorry. Joel Redman, of course, cutting a promo about using Pete Dunne as a stepping stone. Afanoy Jr., of course, is getting himself ready for his main event match. Alex Reynolds knows how to cut a promo, so that's always good. I remember he can at least do that. Excalibur books Zack Sabre Jr. and Alex Reynolds for next month. So we'll set that up here. Alex Reynolds, Zack Sabre Jr. One more time. All right. The next, Alex Reynolds and Yuma. Good one. Matt Cage just ran the distraction for that. Juice Robinson, of course, cutting a promo. Cody Hall beating the crap out of him. Of course, that got an F because overness is stupid. And about solid ring reaction, not much of my heat amasses. Drew with Caleb Conley. Yeah. Double stoppage. We'll have the big blow-off next month. In fact, I will set that up now because I know I'm just going to forget. Amasis, Caleb Conley. Alright. I don't know. I didn't really do... Should I try to do like 2 out of 3 falls? Those are usually good rubber match things, isn't it? Let me see about doing that. 2 out of 3 falls. I could just do Lucha Libre, I guess. Wait, what? Why timed entrances? That doesn't make... Here, 2 out of 3 falls. Alright, so Amasis. God damn it. And Caleb Conley. Miss versus Caleb Conley. 2 out of 3 falls. That's gonna be like my big, it's like, oh, you need a rubber match? Well, let's make sure you win. You have to make sure you win. 2 out of 3 falls, because I think I've done one already. That's gonna be like my old school cage match. Like, back in the old days when cage matches would solve everything, or hell, even with the modern day stuff where like the Hell in a Cell would solve it, even then it still didn't completely solve it, but that's gonna be my 2 out of 3 falls is gonna settle my stuff for right now. Sorry, getting something to drink, hang on. Done doing a thing. His dialogue's a mess. That's alright. We'll just keep a script off on him then. Afanoy Jr. enjoyed the freedom to go on script. Shane Hollister improvised well, and of course Zack Sabre Jr. not a promo cutter. I'm shocked. Alright. Alright, an extremely poor match. Afanoy Jr. defeated Marty Scurll in a strap match. 21-51, Afanoy Jr. was the first to touch all the corners during the match. We also had Scurll, but accidentally hit Scurll. Afanoy Jr. wins the Magnum Pro Heavyweight title in front of 36 people. I could perform better if you use me in matches that suit my skills. Put me a brawl-based match. It's not play to my strengths. Really? Fucking Mr. Umbrella-wearing goddamn anarchist motherfucker, you can't brawl? Why do you have a character like that? And then like, oh, I'm a technical-based athlete. What the fuck? And then that little ditty there where Afa, Shane Hollister, and Zack Sabre Jr. do their thing. D-minus, that was okay, you know. We'll give Marty Scurll some encouragement. I'm going to give Alex Reynolds some props for the fact that he could... he can talk. And what was it? Dalton Castle and the Big O. Let's compliment him on a good performance. The Big O did well. Marty Scurll seems pleased. Alex Reynolds was happy. The Big O seemed pleased. Cool. Big O put on a good match, a solid match. That's very interesting. Marty Scurll's feeling the effects of a recent grueling schedule. Gotcha. Well, I'm not going to be using you for a little bit anyway, so cool. So now we wait. I will set up the next event. We'll get to the end of the month here and check everything out. First off, let's see. We did our thing. Oh, the newest NXT TakeOver. Anything happened? Samoa Joe retained his title. Peyton Royce retained her title. There wasn't a confrontation between Johnny Gargano and Samoa Joe. Nia Jax defeated JoJo. Okay. Cool. What a boring-ass NXT TakeOver that would be, I think. Samoa Joe and Alex Riley. That got a B-. Holy shit. I mean, that was like clearly the best thing on the deal too. It's like clearly the best segment was, can you imagine just being online and be like, clearly the best thing about NXT TakeOver was that Alex Riley Samoa Joe match. I mean, let's give Alex Riley some props here for how good of a performance he did. No, that. Boy, would I shit my pants to see something. Like, if that happened, I would shit myself. Let's compliment Alex Riley on an amazing performance he had against Samoa Joe for the NXT title. Is Alex Riley still technically employed with the WWE? I forget. I don't remember. Okay. See, okay, he is retired. Oh, they're using him as he's a personality. Christian. What is he there as? He's there as Christian. But what does he do? Who knows? He's just there. He's just one of those guys that just shows up once in a while. So we'll save it for Friday and hope to God I can actually put on a show for that point. But we'll see. Okay, so we'll move there because I think that would get me. I know Sean Merriman left WWE. I mean, is Sean Merriman like, I don't think he's doing anything really. Might be doing something wrestling related, but I know the only time he was doing anything wrestling related was with WWE, so I don't see him continue to do something like that. I don't know. I bet you it's probably like, oh, he's out of the business. Oh, good. You know what? Let's do some of their new album. I'd like to hear it. Oops. Alright, let's see what happened. Sunday! It's probably just something stupid like a contract extension. He's unhappy with the push you're giving him. And we're facing bankruptcy. But that always happens, and then we make money. Okay, so you should be a main event guy. Here, how about this? Let's just auto-push everybody. Okay, main eventer, upper mid-carder, road agent, mid-card. So Caleb Conley went down to mid-card. Kobe Carino, Dalton Castle went down to mid-card. Announcer, upper mid-card, referee, upper mid-card. Main event, lower mid-card, main event. Women's upper mid-card, lower mid-card. Upper mid-card and main eventer, cool. Who wasn't happy? It was Amasis, wasn't it? Amasis was irritated. You're happy with your current role. I wonder if I could. Oh, I can't really do anything to make him happier. Maybe if he beats Caleb Conley, which I'll probably end up doing anyway. He might like that. Oh God, remember Michael Tarver? Jesus Christ, he was terrible. Yeah, he was not all that great. Ah, well. TNA Lockdown. Anything cool happened? Lashley defeated Jeff Jarrett. Bobby Roode retained the King of the Mountain title. Wolves retained the World Tag Team titles. Lady Tapa retained the Knockouts title. Ethan Carter III. I forgot he's still the X Division champion. That's great. Sanjay Dutt defeated Rockstar Spud. Tyrus defeated Mahabali Shira. Tigre Uno defeated Micah. EC3 defeated DJ Z. Lady Tapa defeated Angelina Love. Mannequin Mordetsky defeated Aiden O'Shea and Kenny King. Interesting. Brawl involving Lashley and Eddie Edwards. Interesting. And then the Wolves go right out to beat the Hardy Boys. So Eddie Edwards was involved in a brawl with the world champion, and then the Wolves just decide to bitch out the Hardys. Good. That's good. Next, you say with Kurt Angle and Bobby Roode. Maybe they'll have Bobby Roode and Kurt Angle for the King of the Mountain title. Bobby Roode defeated Abyss. Kurt Angle defeated Drew Galloway. Yeah, that's good. Have your 45-year-old guy defeat the guy who's actually hot and has some momentum. That's a great idea. Lashley defeated Jarrett. Yeah, that's good. Have Jeff Jarrett. 2016, and Jeff Jarrett is headlining goddamn TNA pay-per-views. I mean, I know it's not actually that, but I wouldn't be shocked. Like, oh look, Jeff Jarrett's fighting for the TNA world title. Who'd be shocked? Hey, Takeshi Morishima, what the hell has he been doing since Ring of Honor? That's a guy I want. I forgot all about him. I need to go look him up. Fucking Artie Evans. Goddamn Archibald Peck. Goddamn it. I need to check him out. Did I at one point actually look up Archibald Peck? Fucking I need to look up Artie Evans. He can't be that expensive. Cool. IGF have made a contract. Wow. Inoki's trying to get EC3. Networks are scheduled. Oh my god. Paul Levesque has been removed as head booker of WWE. Triple H is not the guy anymore. Andy Simmons is removed as head booker of Revolution Pro. JC Rotten has been removed as the head booker of IWA Mid-South. Dude, Triple H isn't running WWE anymore. That is amazing. We're still not big enough right now to try to do anything with any of that stuff. But hey, look at that. Actually, our momentum went up from F- to F. So hey, we got something going for us. Is that really? That's amazing. Yeah, it's up to 6%. Look at that momentum, boys. We're getting there. Prestige is going to go up eventually, too. Look at that. We're moving up in the world. Extreme Rules. What happened at Extreme Rules? R-Truth defeated Hugo Knox. Chad Gable defeated Heath Slater. And on the main show, Fandango defeated Scott Dawson in the opener. Baron Corbin and Colin Cassidy. Oh my god. Dude, what a fucking team that would be. Baron Corbin and Colin Cassidy. Team Beast the fuck out. Defeated Neville and the man now known as Mad Braddox. Billy Kay and Dana Brooke defeated Nikki Bella and Naomi. Dude, Baron Corbin and Colin Cassidy would be fucking beastly. Oh my god. I'm just imagining how insane that would be. Like, you put those two together, you probably have yourselves a pretty formidable tag team. Now, would it be interesting? Would it be as interesting as Baron Corbin by himself, being the whole lone wolf thing? Well, I'm sure if he was stuck with someone who was decently entertaining, he'd be more entertaining to watch. Colin probably wouldn't be as entertaining without Enzo. But you never know. Just two big boys just beasting the fuck out of everybody. Speaking of beasting... Luke Harper defeated Devon Dudley. And then Cesaro defeated Bubba Ray Dudley to retain the United States title. That's pretty cool. Ryback defeated Mojo Rawley to retain the Intercontinental title. Why is Mojo Rawley fighting on a WWE pay-per-view for the Intercontinental title? Becky Lynch retained the WWE Divas title against Brie Bella. When the hell did she get that? Oh, I think she got a confrontation involving The Rock and Bray Wyatt, and it got an A. Fucking A. I think that would have been amazing to see. Just what, I don't care what it is, just motherfucking The Rock and Bray Wyatt. Holy shit, that'd be great. Of course, The Rock would probably end up winning, but still. Dolph Ziggler and John Cena, of course, tag team champions, defeated the Lucha Dragons to retain. Confrontation involving Brock Lesnar and Seth Rollins. I believe that that would be an A. Those were pretty A segments that led up to that battleground match between Lesnar and Rollins. Speaking of which, Seth Rollins defeated Eric Rowan. Put it in the books, everybody. Eric Rowan fought for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship in this game at Extreme Rules 2016. What the hell does Eric Rowan do between now and Extreme Rules where he gets a championship match? Now, of course, this is not how it actually happened, considering Seth Rollins is injured and blahzy blahzy. just because of how the storylines go in real life, it's amazing that this is the main event and that this happened. Daniel Bryan and The Miz teaming together would be fucking hilarious, just with all the history that they've had. Just Daniel Bryan and The Miz, like, opposites attract one more time, and they're taking on Stardust and Titus O'Neil. Just, yeah, because of recent storylines, the fact that Stardust and Titus O'Neil would be teaming together is just hilarious to me. But yeah, sure, why not? Wow. Okay, so how much money did I make? I made $1,700. I'm not making as much. I didn't make nearly as much money as I would have liked to on sponsors, but I made up that money in miscellaneous stuff. I can't wait to get go from local to small. That would be nice. Merchandise went up again. It always has those on-again, off-again months. This was an on month. So I don't know what miscellaneous money ends up happening with that, but oh well. It seemed to work out. How much, with merchandise sales did pretty insane. I'm still doing DVD home video. I'd like to do, I don't know how much money that's making me. I'd really like to know, like, how much money DVD sales are making me, if that has anything to do with why I make any money like that at all. Oh, well. But either way, I got just under $5,000, which means probably within one or two more months I can do another, and probably do another two show month. As you can tell, the last one seemed to do all right. Once I get about $8,000 set up, I can still have enough money to put on a good show. So probably a couple more months if I can get a couple of solid months of making some money. I think I could probably do it. Let's see, May, June, probably July. Considering we're in May right now, I can do May and June, and then probably July would be... July would probably be a two-show month. Because I'd like to get up... Let's see. I needed to get to F+ in order to become small, if I remember that right. I need F+ of importance, and I got an F right now. So, if I get to F plus importance, I mean, just because I get to F plus size wise doesn't mean in importance I'll move up there, but you know, we'll see. I am currently sitting at 8.1, so 9. Let's see, 9, 9, 9, 10, 8. So that fourth show. So we'll do May, June, July. Two shows in July, and then by August, that should be the one that gets a whole bunch of people there. Once we hopefully go small, go from local to small, and then that first year, that anniversary show will be pretty cool. So that's this month. Deciding if I want to do another month or not, but I'll at the very least be cutting off this video. And, so yeah. That's how that's gonna go. We got a big, show set up for Infamous 10. Where's the pre-booking? There we go. Alex Reynolds vs. Zack Sabre Jr. Again, the rematch. Amasis vs. Caleb Konley, 2 out of 3 falls. May or may not headline, probably. Reynolds and Zack Sabre Jr. may be a better bet to headline. We'll see. And of course, we have our new Magnum Pro Heavyweight Champion, Afa Inouye Jr. After 7 months of Marty Scurll, we have ourselves a new champion. So, I'm looking forward to the future here. We just got a few more shows until I move up into that all-important F-minus category, or F-plus category, and then hopefully that moves us into F-plus importance, and then we can be small, because I know that probably comes with a bump up in money. So, we'll definitely check that out. So, alright, thank you guys for watching this. I almost said thank you guys for coming out. Like, I'm so used to that, but I'm not actually streaming this. Blah. So yeah, thank you guys to the guys who watch this. Yeah, hopefully I'll be actually streaming this sooner rather than later, of course. I'm trying to, you know, figure out, you know, who I'm going to, where I'm gonna live and everything else with that, and I wanna try to do that as quickly as possible. Did they ever find anything with the next booker? It's still vacant. Oh damn, they're down to cult size. Ah, that's not good. Oh, we're gonna be coming up on NXT. As far as size, well, no, they got a lot of grades in a lot of places. Holy crap. Oh, that's their maximum size. They're at what they've been as their maximum size. They cannot rise above cult size due to their status as being a child company. So I wonder what's considered a regional company then. I wonder. They're regional. What does regional entail? Whoops. I mean, I don't have any, let's see, E-plus importance in one region, okay. And then cult would be D-plus importance in two regions. So, let's just focus on getting to small, and then the next big step will be regional. And then after that, I could start going other places, hopefully. Actually, hopefully, by the time I get to regional, if I remember right... I gotta try to remember this. Okay, E plus importance in one region. So if I become a regional promotion, let me look. TV networks. I think it was MAV-TV was the one that is gonna be the one that I would be putting on. Minimum prestige, F plus. Minimum popularity, E plus. Alright, so being a regional show, probably by the time I get to E plus popularity, I should have F plus prestige as well. So when I... That'll be the next thing. I'll be getting to small, hopefully within the next few months. And then I don't know what E plus is. I don't know why I'm thinking so far ahead. It doesn't really, I'm going to forget it, I'm sure, at some point. But I'll just see where E plus lies. So we get to 11 and that's F plus. E plus is probably like 20, isn't it? Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, this is gonna be forever. 29 gets us to E plus. Let's just exit. That shouldn't have screwed in anything. Whew. Okay, so we got a little ways before we become a decent-sized regional promotion. But hopefully once we get into small, hopefully we can start cranking out shows faster. Because someone had told me, because I never really paid too much attention to this, because honestly, this is the first time in this game that I've done a 0000 promotion. So I never paid too much attention to sponsorship income. And someone had said that I get a pretty big bump in sponsorship when I go from local to small. Which means I can hire better people if I wanted to, which means I could run more shows because I get a lot more money. So I'll be able to do more stuff with that. And, you know, hopefully I can run, you know, at least 2 shows a month once I hit small. But that's going to be probably at least 4 or so videos away from this. And hopefully that won't take me another month or so to get the next one up. By the way, while I remember, let's check out RD Evans and let's see how much money he wants. $600 a month. Okay. That's a thing. I mean, he's not... He's good. He's kind of popular. I mean, not in the Midwest, but we can change that. Let's put him on the short list, because at only $600, he's probably going to be one of the guys that I'm going to be willing to bring up. Let me just try to put something in real quick. Because I just need to check something real quick. Ramstein! Okay. So what does my short list look like right now? Because these are people that you could probably look forward to in a few episodes. Oh god. Actual female wrestlers in Vea Mio Shirai. Because she's not retired in this game yet. Io Shirai, bring her back. Evie. I may or may not use Gregory Iron. I may or may not use Brian Cage. I may or may not use Jesus Rodriguez. Well, I think he can talk. Yeah, he can really talk, and he can kind of wrestle, too. So, fucking Ricardo Rodriguez is probably going to be one of those guys. How much is he? Okay, I'm too small for him right now. Right now. Maybe when I turn small, that might be different. EC3. I'm too small for EC3 now. Fuck you. RD Evans, Sugar Duggerton. Toriano's probably he wouldn't be able to join us anyway because he's on a written contract. That's right. Doesn't really matter. But yeah, I'll be filling out a women's division with actual good wrestlers, and then probably bring in Ricardo Rodriguez, RD Evans, Sugar Duggerton. Maybe EC3 might want to join at that point. Brian Cage, I don't know if I want... $700 a month for Brian Cage. He'd still be good. Brian Cage is probably be a good addition. Fill out the roster a little bit more, because technically, the way I run my roster right now is I only need like 12 people. If I remember right. I only need 12, I have 18. Don't even need a third of my roster, but I still use them anyway. So, boy, that would To be fair, if I used a couple less people and then just filled out more matches, I mean, I'd be getting an extra. Well, that's the thing. The people that I'd be getting rid of. Ugh, God, like, Caleb Conley, probably not. I mean, who would be the guy that I would be getting rid of? That's Mark Sherman, maybe, but he's 290. Matt Cage is 340. I mean, that might be a guy, but. Pete Dunne's 290. I mean, I probably wouldn't be saving more than maybe $600. I mean, it's still $600. Pego's only 230. I like using Yuma. Even at 200, he's still good. And Zack Sabre Jr. is more than worth 330. And I'm not going to get rid of Shane Hollister at 380 because he's very good. Maybe Matt Cage. Matt Cage might be a guy I'll look into getting rid of, maybe. So if I get rid of a heel, maybe a face, like maybe Mark Sherman, who knows. I'm not really doing much with Matt Cage or Mark Sherman. Alright, so yeah, thank you guys, the people who watch this. I do greatly appreciate it. I've been rambling for the last 10 minutes, I remember, because I looked at it and said like a minute 12. Now I'm at a minute 21, or an hour 12 and an hour 21. But yeah, it's a lot of rambling. But yeah, thank you guys for the ones who watch this. And I'll make sure to be pumping out videos on a more regular basis now that I'm not feeling like death. So yeah, I'll make sure to do that and do more stuff for you, because yeah, I really do enjoy playing this. I do enjoy playing other things, and I do want to get back into that and produce some videos. Despite my internet being shit, I do want to do that. So thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time.